Last time I made a tutorial about PNGtubers, we created this abomination. Testing. 1, 2, 3. It's me. If you haven't seen that video yet, it's gonna introduce you to the concept of creating an easy PNGtuber. Right now, there is a heat wave in Europe, and I've been having some health issues, so I'm not always camera ready. That's why I decided to make a PNGtuber of myself, using pictures of myself. So let's figure it out. Oh, and by the way, today's sponsor is you. Thank you. All right, so Veadotube Mini is the software we're gonna be using. Again, already have a tutorial on that. And we need to gather the information. I can't keep talking with this thing moving around. So we know that we have options for about 4 different pictures. It's gonna be closed mouth blinking, so eyes closed, open mouth blinking. And then we can add like some motion transition if we want to. All right, another thing that we know is that we can have multiple states. So if we wanted to have another set of images for, hey, I'm currently being raided, so I'm gonna act surprised and happy at the same time. So I can have 4 other images. I'm playing a spooky game. I am scared, so I'm gonna have 4 different images of me being scared. By the way, for the people who don't wanna show their face, don't worry. Eventually, I'll come around to finding the easiest way you can create your own PNGtuber with like animations that you can generate online for free. But today's not that day, let's go. So it turns out on Windows, there's an app called Camera, and it looks like this. You can select your webcam. You're not gonna have the best quality ever, but it's the best way of quickly capturing images from any video capture device that you may have. I'm gonna try to stand still for this. So it's gonna be mouth closed, mouth open, mouth closed blinking, mouth open blinking, right? I'm only gonna do 1 state, so you're gonna pick, you know, what expression you want, but I'm gonna try to stay a little neutral, maybe with my eyes kind of big, so it's very expressive. And you can just click on that little thing here, or if you want, you can put a timer on the left side too. Of course, everything I'm showing here, you can do it by taking pictures with your phone, for example. All right, let's do mouth closed, mouth open. I'm gonna smile a little bit when I have the mouth open. Okay, mouth open blinking. Mouth closed, blinking. That should be all we need. Nope. My kitchen door just opened by itself. Or you can click on the bottom right to see them. And then top right, click on open folder. There you go. Let's see what we have. This picture, eyes open, mouth open, but I don't want that. I actually want that. So I'm gonna delete that one. Boom. So then when I have mouth open, it's gonna be that. A little dramatic, but I'll take it. And then mouth closed. Okay, this is where the magic happens. We're gonna go to a website called remove.bg. BG stands for background. I'm trying to show you something that is very accessible, so I'm not gonna go through Photoshop. I'm not gonna do anything fancy to it. We're gonna see how well it actually cuts out my hair. So straight from the camera roll, I wanna go ahead and drag this. Oh, this is me testing this earlier. Boom. It's actually doing a pretty good job. What? That's great. I haven't tried the edit button, but here you have the option to download HD, so 1080p, or 600 by 325, which is considerably smaller, but we're using this in Veadotube, so we don't need high quality. Plus, high quality here is not free. So click download. It's gonna ask you where you wanna put it. I'm gonna create a folder called PNG, and this one was the base layer, right? Boom, call it base. We're gonna go back to our folder. We're gonna find the mouth open. We're gonna drag, drop. Hopefully it lets me do 4 images. Boom, it's gonna do its little magic. There you go, click download. And this is mouth open. Nice, okay. Go back to the folder again. Mouth open blinking, drag, drop. Mouth open blinking. And finally, we will have mouth closed blinking. And download, mouth closed, blinking. Now let's go back to Veadotube. If, actually, I kinda wanna save this. I'm gonna click save Veadotube Mini, and I'm gonna save my boy Bilbo, just in case I wanna pull it out. So I'm gonna click on close mouth image, and I'm gonna go find what we just created. Boom, there you go. I actually already have some effects, so let me turn those off to represent what it would probably look for you if it's the first time you're using it. Open mouth image. Okay, there you go. This is the basic. Close mouth blinking. And then finally, open mouth blinking. Testing, 1, 2, 3. And I blink and everything. I think that's pretty cool. I can have a transition when I speak, it bounces a little bit. I can make it so that it has a different motion when the mouth is open. Testing. It's vibing, so it's slowly moving. You can see the example here, and I can just have the same vibing feel to it right there. Now, if you want to add this to OBS Studio, for example, you would go ahead and just add, turn off the preview. I would go into my scene, click on the plus to add a new source. I would find game capture. I would name it whatever you want. I would find capture a specific window here. Click window and click Veadotube Mini. There I am. And I can click allow transparency. Boom. Now I'm transparent and I'm here. How does this look? Ba 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 ba. And of course, I can add some effects to it. I can add some filters. I can do color correction if I want it to look a little bit better. But I think this is going to be very useful for me in the future. So hopefully this was useful to you. So hopefully this was useful to you. Make sure you go watch my other tutorial on how to use Veadotube Mini. And also make sure you click that subscribe button. It's very important to me and you will make sure to not miss my other videos. Anyways, thank you so much for watching. Go out there, make me proud. Guy level and mini guy level out.